So many people wander through life without ever owning the time and space that they're in.
You want to get to the Super Bowl? You got to feel being at the top. There's going to be a moment where you're going to say, is it worth getting to the top? It's worth it. It's worth it as a husband. It's worth it as a father. It's worth it as a friend. And it's worth it as a football player. One foot after the other. Dig your fingernails into the hillside. Don't let go. Just keep climbing.
Let's go! Stay positive, stay positive.
Want to get to the top. That journey, there's going to be some times where it's easy.
Let's go!
There's some times it's a little hard, some bumps in the road. There's going to be some really hard times. When you're able to dig so deep into your core, into your soul, and find something you didn't know you had, just know that it's worth it.
On the Nike campus in Beaverton, Oregon, the climb commences. 18 of the nation's best high school quarterbacks compete in a six-day event called the Elite 11. Alumni include NFL stars Tim Tebow, Andrew Luck, and Ben Roethlisberger. Coined as a camp petition, the Elite 11 is led by Super Bowl winning quarterback Trent Dilfer, who offers a holistic approach to coaching.
My vision for this was, we want to tap into your soul, know who you are at your core. Yeah, we want him to throw the ball better. We want him to move his feet better. We want him to read a defense better. But more than anything else, we want the whole person to be better. And we want the whole person to have more tools to be successful with what they do next.
You got the weight of the world on your shoulders for some reason. Okay, relax, let it go.
What you say to yourself will determine your success this week. Not what I say, not what any other coach said, what you say to yourself. We gotta get your bodies right, we gotta get your minds right, we gotta get your souls right.
Trent's compassion comes from a source of great pain. In 2003, he lost his 5.5-year-old son, Trevin, to heart disease.
That type of pain, that breaks you. Watching that loss affect your family so negatively, that was the hardest thing.
He's the only one that knows, you know, has been through exactly what I've been through, you know, so. We're there for one another, and you know, our family just is super important to us.
Like through hard times, and like when we need to be told, like the hard stuff, he'll tell us.
Whenever he gets a chance to help us with something, or teach us something, or ask us about our day, whatever it is, he does.
Come on, Tom.
The way he loves us, me and my sisters and then my brother, carried on into the high school kids. I think losing my brother probably makes him want to be around these kids more.
Our son, Trevin, he'd be 15 and a half. That's kind of around, you know, the age that he's working with, you know, a couple years older. So I do think it fills a void. He's always working on it nonstop.
Nice, Kellen. Move it outside. Get it outside.
We will not be together on our 20th anniversary because he will be at Elite 11. But I think this is a positive thing.
I think my greatest motivation through this is I get a second chance that not a lot of parents of lost kids get. I get to go pour out everything I have into young men's lives. And those that keep climbing are going to be the ones that ultimately develop the skill set to be successful as a player, but also as a person.
Father, we need you right now. And Lord, see him through. Wherever he may go, bless him on his way to success.
Amen. Amen.
Deshaun Watson's journey to the Elite 11 has been an uphill climb. In early 2012, he discovered distressing news about his mother.
She called me in the living room, and she was, just kind of tearing up a little bit, and she told me she had cancer. And then, I just started crying and bawling. She said, be strong, and we're going to get through it together.
With his mom in the hospital recovering from surgery, Deshaun led his high school to the state championship. Tongue cancer forever changed Deanne Watson, but it did not change the pride she has for her son.
I'm glad to remember that the advantage is there's no other place that I'd rather have you be right now is to do the thing that you meant to do.
You mean the whole world to me. Going through cancer, getting through that and not complaining means the world, and tells me that I can do anything in the world. I can't even really explain, how much I love you, and I love everything about you, and glad that you're my mom.
I love you too.
Will Greer's approach to football is a family affair. His father, Chad, is also his high school head coach.
Here we go. I went through it. It's good work. It's all good.
Together, they won a state championship, as Will set a national record with his passing performance in one particular game.
Right after the game, I heard, you threw for 700 yards, and then somebody said, you threw for 900, and all this different stuff. Well, I think the official came out the next day, it was like 800 and...
837. I started coaching in college. I mean, as a college student, just something I love to do, and my dream was always to someday be a high school coach.
The thing that he's drilled into me since I was a kid is footwork. My footwork has excelled since I was young. I've literally probably done multi-million three-step, five-step drops in my life.
One, two, three, check post, come back pearl, good. Nice move in the pocket, nice job. Avoiding the rush, did good.
We do a pretty good job separating coach and dad on the field, at least. My parents got divorced at a young age, and it's obviously not easy. Football was always like an out for me. I spent time with my mom doing other things, but me and my dad always had football.
I hate it for him and for my other two boys. I wish more than anything I never would have come to that. Every second I can spend with him is something I'm gonna cherish for a lifetime.
It's a good ball, throw him away from the safety, right?
You've taught me life lessons through football, and it's kind of all came together, the actual Elite 11. It's a prestigious event, and it's an honor to be invited.
I'm just proud to be your dad, and I love you.
On his way to the Elite 11, Manny Wilkins has longed for a father's guidance. When Manny was just 10 years old, his life was forever changed.
My dad was in and out of prison and promised me that he'd be around and be that the father that he needed to be pretty much for me. I guess he was, into the drugs and stuff like that. My grandma called my mom, and I just heard my mom scream, and just was crying for 15 minutes. She's like, your father has passed away. When my father passed, I got myself caught up into, liquor and stuff like that. And, I was ditching school. I was hanging out with seniors as a freshman, just trying to be that cool kid. Pretty much my freshman year, I got no credits in high school.
He wasn't really doing much in school, and he was kind of couch surfing for a while on his friends' couches. So we brought him out to just get a little break and have a little summertime with us. And here we are 3 years later, and he's still here.
After my uncle and my aunt took me in, it was like, what am I doing with my life? we gotta get this going. My uncle got involved with myself and we just were like, let's play football. And I ended up making every single credit that I missed back in one summer.
You know, he's real focused at his craft and he understands you gotta work your ass off in the classroom and on the field, and you have to train and sacrifice some of the stuff a normal teenager gets to do because of the extra work you wanna do to get to that quarterback level.
Hey, work hard on three. One, two, three, work hard.
I wanna be a role model to somebody that's younger than me and be that person that my son, when I have a son or daughter, can look up to and be proud of. I'm one of the 18 quarterbacks in the country to get this opportunity. It's just an amazing opportunity that's set in front of me.
Well, today's the first day of Elite 11, and the guys are coming in, flying in right now. We've got a couple loads coming, and get thrown right into the mix real quick. It'll be a busy day for them. Once they hit the ground, they're going nonstop.
Are you guys excited, ready to make it happen?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Nope. Great, great.
It's kind of different for me. I've never been on the West Coast or the Oregon, so I'm seeing all these mountains, and I was just anxious to get out here and see what Oregon was like and see what Trent and them had planned for us.
If I don't get selected, I'm still going through the process and being able to enjoy it. It's going to be great. It's going to be crazy.
My thing is it's hard coming from a lot of adversity. I used to use it as an excuse, but now it's me using it for some positive things to do with my life and get my life turned around and make sure I'm doing what I need to do so I can be successful.
Guys, we are so excited you're here. I can promise you one thing, this week will be a journey, one you'll never forget. All the tools we give you physically, mentally, and emotionally will be transferable to the football field, but most importantly, life. We are wasting our time if we're just trying to make you great football players. Make this world a better place to live. And toss a couple dimes while you're at it.
At the Elite 11, there is no warm-up. Competition begins the moment players step off the plane. Out of the 18 invited, 11 will be named elite. Only one will be MVP.
8 minutes, no friends, proper footwork. Welcome to the Revolution Movement. No excuses. Either you a rider, if you not, then you useless. This is rebel music. This is televised, so don't act like you tuned in clueless. Let this creep into your system while you're grooving. Since I'm in the mood, I let the sisters get a few in. That's when I take a step back. That's when I get to view it. Be exact. Be exact with the ball.
I demand the same excellence the San Francisco 49ers do, the Green Bay Packers do, the New York Giants do. I only know one way.
Here's where the tough win. Nobody cares if you're tired!
I think training the mechanics, the physical is very simple. Science helps us there. But this game's so mental. It would be cheating if we didn't emphasize that just as much as the physical.
The competitors are expected to learn an NFL-style playbook. This is no high school film room.
It's been hard for me to be that tired and still try and push through some of the things that we're doing.
Double F belly pass left, Manning, F shallow cross.
The playbook this year is overwhelming because these people have the capacity to pull it off.
I believe 17-year-old quarterbacks can take an NFL curriculum, and that's what we give them. All right, sprint right Montana. This guy's running a Dalton. You run some Rogers twist, H-pop. It's at least a two-hit, two-shuffle throw. Three-jet breeze, H-pop from the middle of the field. It's almost like an inside bang eight. 2 yards inside the numbers, 18 to 22 yards down the field.
In an age of touchscreen technology, players simulate the immediate decisions that must be made on the field.
can they be taught something different they've been taught for years and immediately apply it?
X and Z hinge, H pop.
Quarterback's a lot more than just throwing the ball. You gotta be mentally strong, you gotta be a leader.
After the first day of evaluations, under-recruited Sean White is surprising many.
Number 17 in, many rolled their eyes at me when I invited them.
Yeah, I'm just in the hotel room, just relaxing. Trent wants us to like work on the verbiage of the plays and stuff. He wants us to get that stuff down for tomorrow, so that's what I gotta work on that.
Cool. Is your roomie here?
Yeah. There's a lot of good guys out here, but I mean, I think I'm doing well. I think I'm throwing good.
Keep working hard. Keep coaching.
Yeah, I will. Yep. But thanks.
All right, man. All right.
See you. Love you too.
Bye.
What's up, Bob?
What's up, babe?
Will Greer has an advantage over all the other competitors. To have his father present is also to have his head coach.
You just tell me, just flash it at me and I'll read it back to you.
Right? I like having him here. I mean, he's never been crowding me or anything like that. He just kind of hangs out. He just kind of takes it all in, gives me some feedback, and he knows what he's talking about. He's been around the game for a while.
Tough right, two jet, Freeman, X tag, on one.
A little stronger. I'll look down at the floor.
I don't look at it as if dad's here watching or whatever. I do my thing. He sees it, gives me some feedback, and regardless of what happens, I still have that. But my goal in coming here is I'm gonna compete, and I wanna show that I'm the best one here.
Train left, Fox 3, hot Hasselbeck on one.
Hey, you worked the huddle nicely. I felt a little eye contact, you got me in on it, right? It's not just over there you're throwing to, that's good.
The next day, the playbook must be executed. Some excel, while others struggle to find the union between arm and mind.
Double right, three jet Marino, X Weed.
Don't be afraid to fail right now. We're not great now, right? We're still got a couple days. I'd rather you feel conviction than be tentative and whispering.
Motion to gun empty right, gone right, Smith, D back line, 1-on-1. Ready?
Hey, I'm George, not that looks good. We got time, let's put
it on. Motion to gun, empty right, going right.
Smith Z backline.
I haven't mastered anything. I'm taking baby steps, but it's taught me a lot about myself. I'm not as tough mentally as I thought I was.
With more coaches on site than quarterbacks, struggling players like Jacob Park receive the individual attention required to succeed.
I'll take those notes and I'll use them in a one-on-one player. How much different is it than what you do in high school?
Some of the plays aren't much different. The way you call the play, how long the play is. That's what I'm having trouble with.
I do that on purpose to make it harder and teach you how to learn. You see it, don't you?
I've been to I can't tell you how many camps. I don't like going to camps anymore. I was honestly not even about to come to this camp, but I'm so glad I did. This isn't even a camp. Yeah, they're teaching us football stuff, but it seems like there's a lesson in everything.
What you say to yourself will determine your success this week. Not what I say, not what any other coach say. What you say to yourself, I can do this, I got this, it's not too hard. You know what I mean? Just self-talk will be the key. And that carries over for life, man. I'm a parent of three daughters. It's all about self-talk. All right?
Trent has a real rich understanding that it's a complicated game. And to make it simple, we have to be fully present.
Sports psychologist Dr. Michael Gervais is on site to fine-tune the player's psyche for football.
Have a vision and make a decision to commit to that vision. The way to build confidence comes from one place and one place only, which is what you say to yourself, okay? If you can hold on to why you're good and you can embrace challenge in front of you, you got a shot.
It helps out a lot. My arm was hurting.
And my knee was bugging me a lot too. But I said, you know, I can do this. You know, I wasn't thinking, oh, my knee hurts or my shoulder hurts. I was thinking the play at the time, my drop, what I need to do to be successful. Next ball, it's a dime, you know what I mean? It's quieting the mind and being a competitor.
Good, Manny, perfect.
The Elite 11 also provides the most elite on-field mentors, college football's best quarterbacks, and NFL stars like Aaron Rodgers offer a once-in-a-lifetime afternoon of advice.
Got any tips for me?
Just challenge yourself because you have all the ability in the arm. Just challenge yourself every time you're doing a drill work. Keep your eyes down.
Yes, sir.
Work on that first step that you take. Can you take it? Your first step is coming here. So see, you're coming behind. You're not getting any depth. Tried it. Explode back. That's good. Good first step. I remember looking up to guys who were older than me and had already experienced a lot and done a lot on the college level and just wanting to pick their brains. And it's a big honor for me to come back and just try and give back to these guys.
They continue to elevate you up. You got to kick it up to another level. You got to continue to elevate your game. Not all y'all can win. There's 18 guys in this room. Not everybody can take the cake. You got to make sure you work even harder. Something about the game, man. Still learning it, still trying to figure out exactly what it is. Maybe you might not ever figure it out, but it's special. I can see it in all y'all's eyes. Y'all here for a reason. Y'all out here working.
We love having you, man.
As day breaks, the Elite 11 staff break down the boundaries of the young men in attendance. Physically, they will be tested like never before.
People are just in their zone. I gotta get them out of it.
They come in as celebrity stars, and we very quickly help them realize how little they really are.
Their bodies are getting
big boy trained, and then we put big boy pressure on them.
On the run, we moving now.
I pushed myself to limits I didn't know I could push to in that run.
Let's go, let's go, let's go, we go, we go, we go.
Don't make the mistake of thinking you're done.
They said, all right, we're gonna get into the squat position and we're just gonna see which partner can hold it for the longest.
Take your foot out, woo!
Keep going, it's not about winning, it's about taking yourself to the maximum, right?
Every once in a while, you see the triumph of the human spirit. When you see somebody go further than they thought they could go.
Not only did he win, but when he won, he stayed even longer. That showed me that this young man's hungry.
Own this moment!
Own it, David! Come on,
David, own it!
He's hungry to not just prove to himself, because he knows he's great, but he also wants to make a statement and say, hey, if you weren't looking my way, take a look, because I'm here, and I'm legit.
Another inch!
And hold it! Right there. There you go!
Nice job!
You know, I've never did yoga before, so that was the first time for me.
It's fun to watch which ones start comparing themselves to one another, looking over their shoulder. It's fun to watch the ones just trying to survive. But it's really a blast to watch the ones that are at the top and say, yeah, let's go ball. And that, to us as a staff, is a part of finding out who truly has an inner sense of confidence to go do their thing.
That is beautiful.
Number 37, the guy directly in that career, he's killing it. Look at his eyes. He's saying the right things to himself right now.
Will Greer adding a little sauce to this now.
I don't think there's one player as focused or as locked into the present moment as Will.
Physically, you can always push yourself to limits you didn't know. But that mentally and emotionally, I've been challenged more than anything, being as tired as I've been.
Ten of them.
Physically, there is a lot of non-football stuff that plays into you as a quarterback, but I didn't expect it to be as much as they've really done so far.
Most of it is on football, testing your stamina, waking up early every morning, training all through the day, just to stay strong, but it was tough.
When the rubber hits the road, that's what a quarterback is, doing stuff you're not trained to do and adapting and helping your players win.
Later in the week, the quarterbacks are joined by the nation's top high school position players. Strength, speed, and stamina are measured in an NFL-style combine.
That's it, go get it, go get it!
39-6.
The age, the broadness, the emotion, the effort, the will. These kids are amazing.
Yeah, he looks just like me with the shirt off.
Wow. Oh! When they're willing to let every part of them get tested and molded, learn something special about yourself. You've given them the best in terms of the physical, the mental. And I said, you know what? We're failing if that's all we're doing, because they're not all going to play in the NFL. We better equip them to have a solid soul. Trying to put smiles on kids' faces that are struggling with cancer.
Visiting is the Children's Cancer Charity, NCGU, an acronym for Never, Ever Give Up. The goal is to show the players that the quarterback position is one of responsibility and influence.
What's up, man?
Right here.
Keller, how are you?
How you doing, man? I'm well. Nice to meet you.
There it is, it's the touchdown. I'll end the spike, I love it. Do a dance. Yes, yes. You learned 3 routes already, dude.
I'm Deshaun.
Nice to meet you, I'm Angela.
Hey.
This is Alette.
I'm Deshaun.
Nice to meet you.
You know, I couldn't relate with her because my mom had cancer, and I told her how, you know, I felt and dealt with it. And, you know, I talked to her mom about the whole situation.
She had it for maybe a year.
Yeah.
And she went through all the treatment, and it was...
You're familiar.
Yeah, I'm very familiar.
And I told her I was going to keep praying for it and keep in touch with it if I can.
If you could be in their shoes for a day, I'm pretty sure none of us could last it. It's a difficult thing to be around cancer.
Sometimes I have tough days in my life.
Yeah?
Hey, but look at you, dude. You're still strong.
Hey, you look great.
Look at you.
I also lost one of my family members.
Oh.
I clearly miss her very much.
Yeah? You know, he was so open to kind of share his story with me, which really hit home. I know what it feels like to lose something that's close to you.
I lost my father when I was 10. So, you know, I miss him a lot, too, and it's hard. But, you know, you got to learn to... not give up on what you're given.
I never ever give up.
Hey, high five to that. All right, boy.
Never,
good job.
Never gave up.
Go Blues! Go Blues!
Here
he goes.
That night I went home to my room and I sat in there to think about it. It kind of made me realize what Trent and everybody are trying to do for us here. This camp's more about making us men instead of football players.
Day 4. To achieve greatness, complacency cannot set in. All the players must keep climbing.
We say day 1. We're not trying to find the top 11 quarterbacks. We're looking for the top 11 competitors.
You are going to go on some deep dips on this journey. We will make you uncomfortable. The edge of uncomfortable is where you find greatness. It's how you deal in those moments when you're extremely uncomfortable that will decide what you get out of this week and ultimately whether you make the 11 or win the MVP.
My one goal coming in is to win it. I want to win MVP.
That's one of my goals, to be MVP.
Take home the MVP.
Try to win the MVP.
I'm here to win it.
And I want to win. That's just plain and simple how it is. I know myself to be a fierce competitor, and that's what I came here to do, is just compete, not only with these guys, but with myself to get better. Everything else kind of falls into place.
The ball, Will. Here's where the mentally resilient show up. Let's go.
We're just throwing at them in an NFL passing game. And it's not that they've learned it, they've thrived in it.
all these practices, there's 17 other guys who I just love to compete against. This is all I know how to do.
David Blau from Texas comes in here, not as heavily recruited before this process started, and yet owns everything he jumps into.
Nice, nice, nice.
That ball sent a message, Blau. That ball sent a message. Oh, there we go. Boom! Now, see? Deshaun, you think you're throwing this, right? I want it. I have it. I have it. Nope, I don't have it. Pop the feet outside, drill it down the rail, and then chase him as he's scoring.
Deshaun Watson walked into camp with that big smile of his, didn't say much, and all of a sudden said, hey, recognize me, because I'm here and I'm going to ball.
Nice, Deshaun. That's exactly the ball I told you to throw up there. Perfect.
Under-recruited and underestimated. Sean White was one of the last kids invited to camp. But since his arrival, everyone has taken notice.
I just wanted to come with a chip on my shoulder and show everybody that I can throw as good or better than anybody in the country.
He hangs on every bit of wisdom we give him and every teaching we give him, and then the next rep applies it.
Sean, that's a good throw.
So when I take this hitch,
one, two, three.
I think we are all doing a very good job of really being coachable and, you know, not being, you know, just I'm here because I'm good.
Manny, it's the best I've seen you throw it. You're not trying to kill anybody. You're just completing the ball because you're not trying to impress. You're just trying to deal.
Oh, nice throw.
Will, dive. Oh, Deshaun, who can outdo who?
I'm very impressed with how passionate he is about not only football, but about us.
Great job, way to run. I'm so proud of you.
Well, the easy answer to say why Trent cares so much is that, you know, he played the position, right? It's deeper than that with this guy.
Hey, everybody, listen up.
I know that when you hear him stop and pause, because he's gonna get choked up, that he's talking to his son.
I get a second chance, right? I lost my son. I get a chance to parent young boys. I get a chance to influence them.
This is the greatest group of people I've ever worked with. I sat back the last half an hour and I said to myself, look at the coaches, the ball boys, everybody in their sweet spot. Just ripping it. And what happens when that happens? You guys just had the best day I've ever seen high school quarterbacks have. Not even close. And that's a life lesson. It's the same way with families. You're gonna be dads, right? You're gonna lead businesses. You're gonna change the world. You guys are gonna shred people if you continue on this trajectory. I'm so proud of you. I'm so, so proud of you, all right? But we gotta keep it going.
We ready! 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 We ready!
For Trent and his staff, the toughest part of the process is ranking the quarterbacks. This is not a popularity contest. A list of metrics determine who will be defined as elite.
All right, this is gonna be a long one, guys.
The war room settings give us clarity. It's a deeper evaluation. It's a more objective evaluation because you look at some of the raw data.
Let's start with Deshaun.
He's been consistent in every single thing that we've done. He's dynamic athletically, and the dude is Derrick Rose demeanor. I love his demeanor.
He's a pretty gifted passer. I think from an arm talent, he's a four. I don't think we have many much better. I think he can tempo the ball. He can throw fastballs. He can locate. Do you see Deshaun as a guy that has a chance to win this thing?
Yes.
100%. Sean White. I really think there's a few guys in this group that are there. I would call them give me a ball and let me kick your ass type of people. I think Sean's a give me your ball, let me kick your ass type person. He's our closest five, I would
say at this point.
I think by far he is the best distributor
here. Can you see Sean White winning this thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. All right, let's go David Blau.
If I had to pick a winner right now, I'd pick him.
He's my number one. He's my top rated guy right now.
He's first off. He's Drew Brees.
That's why we had him invite him.
From being around him, he's just Drew Brees.
Will Greer. I'm just not going to say anything because I can't figure this kid out.
I think his highs are never too high. His lows are never too low. He can find his happy place, which is what we saw.
He knows what Zen
on the field and yoga.
Yeah. And he's got... Yes, he does. Yep. All right. Now it gets fun. Manny Wilkins.
There are some insecurities, and I think he kind of borders on who am I versus what am I. What do you guys want to hear from me a little bit?
There's two sides of the coin, and I don't think the kid's BS. You look at his back.
I don't think he's BS. I think George said it most profoundly. I don't think he knows who he, if he needs to be him or if it needs to be who he thinks we want him to be.
Which is every freshman quarterback in the United States of America. It's an amazing comeback from what he's come from. So for him to not be sure of himself and still be as positive as he is, I think it's pretty impressive, I'll be honest.
And you guys have a lot of time. All right, we're done.
As game day looms, the 18 quarterbacks are given their first glimpse of where they rank in the Elite 11. The upcoming 2 days of game action will ultimately decide the final standings.
Number one now doesn't mean number one in 2 days. Number one in 2 days means I have to do exactly what I've done and elevate my game even higher.
This means nothing right now. It could be the guy who's at the bottom of their 18 right now could end up number one.
It's not over.
Yeah,
it's just like...
Being number three out of 18 nationally ranked quarterbacks is awesome, but you know, you can still go higher, you know, so that's what I'm gonna try to do and get number one. Hey, David, we're coming for you. We're coming for you. Let's see if you can hold the top.
Hey, sweetie.
Hi, Andy. Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary to you.
20 years of pure bliss, baby.
Yeah. We've had no rocky roads whatsoever, huh?
Not at all. Not at all.
I'm sorry we won't be together on our anniversary. I love you so much.
Everything has built to this. Game day. Who will ascend? Who will fall? Can the quarterbacks of the Elite 11 keep climbing?
...163 of the very best high school football players in the country going to change the landscape of college football and in the future of the National Football League. I'd call that football heaven. I don't know, I love football. Maybe you guys don't. But to me, that's football heaven. This is gonna be epic. I hope you feel it. I feel it. I've been part of some big environments. Let it rip. Have a blast. Encourage one another. Celebrate. Again.
1, 2, 3.
QBs.
Don't try to jam it in there.
No, that's my route. Manny, he was open on time. Throw it on time.
He likes it deep, Dad.
As some front runners faltered, two quarterbacks emerge as MVP favorites. Will Grier and Sean White were able to translate elite training into phenomenal play. The two led their teams to the championship game by making the spectacular seem simple and by making fierce competition look fun.
You know, whether he was ranked first or 18th, what an incredible experience and opportunity for him. I mean, as a dad, again, I'm thrilled that he's had the chance to do this. And as a coach, I'm thrilled. He's gotten great instruction. Oh, he's playing now.
State us. We're us. We came from the 6th seed to make it right here. It's our moment.
In the championship, Sean White struck first. A throw into heavy coverage by Will Grier left his team scoreless.
Hey, don't lose your discipline now. Don't lose your discipline.
Down by 13, Will Grier responded in the second half.
Oh, what a throw. What a throw. That's what we talk about. Trust it, Will. See it, feel it, trust it. Nice.
Money.
Woo!
Thank you. Nice throw, baby. Had a boy.
Wait to see my smart play, baby.
Come on, get another one. Let's go. Come on. Come on, finish.
Work, baby.
Got it.
Yo!
Let's go. Let's go.
That's what it takes. Let's go. That's what it takes to be a pro, dude.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. Red, chance to go!
Sean White had 2 minutes left to lead his team on a game-winning drive.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hey, know your situation. It's a big down now. Greatest focus.
Right here, baby. Right here, D.
Hey.
This is what separates people. Executing.
Keep out of the red zone, D.
As Sean White drove downfield, Will Grier could only watch. And what he saw was a fellow quarterback climb to the Elite 11 summit.
Unbelievable week for you.
Thank you for having me.
No, dude, thank you for being here. That was an unbelievable week on your behalf. What you showed me today is way more than just talent and all that other stuff. You make everybody better. And that's the ultimate goal.
Thank you, sir.
Good job.
How big was that last drive?
It was big. It was either score or lose. Yeah.
In a final coaches meeting, Trent and his staff determine the rankings. Two players dominate the discussion.
I think the discussion we have to have is starting off is probably with Deshaun Watson.
He put us in position to win.
So his performance isn't going to show up in the stat line or the metric because of circumstances.
He looks like he struggles, but he's carrying all this weight and he's trying to make more plays when he thinks he has to and gets himself into jams.
Watson or Wilkins?
I love Manny. I'm a fan of his story. He's battled all the way back.
There might not be a player I'm more proud of than him and how he handled it.
So it's not going to be Watson and Wilkins. So
I know.
I mean, if you're going to get one in the 11, which one would it be?
18 players, 11 to be selected as elite. One final gathering to hear their fate.
So this is the worst part of my year, and the best part. Football is something you do. It's not who you are. And take it from a father of four that's lost one. Life is so full of epic moments that are light years better than your greatest moments in football. And hopefully what we've done is allowed you that perspective. If you make it, you step up. If you don't, you just stay still. Will, I saw you coming into an uncomfortable environment. What the heck is this? And you never flinched. And that no flinch carried over every single day this week. It almost carried over to the extent that he almost won the championship. I'd like to welcome you to the Elite 11 fraternity. Congratulations. Thank you. Please step up. Sean White, as you went through this week, everything you did, you were making a statement to somebody. I don't know who that somebody is. You executed at the highest level, and for that reason, you're part of the fraternity.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Some step up to join the fraternity. Others are left behind. As the elite are named, anxiety heightens. 10 are selected. Only one spot remains. One spot for two players. Deshaun Watson or Manny Wilkins.
Two guys. Same team, you guys can do the math, right? I wasn't sure if you knew who you were coming in this week. I probably know you as well as anybody because you are an alpha. You know, you're not afraid to put yourself out there. You rally these troops every time they need to be rallied. Who'd I call anytime I need anything or text? You. You're my point person. You have to find the ability to find that flow more often. You get out of it too easy. When you start doubting yourself, you doubt yourself bad. You're not going to be in the 11, but thank you very much, man.
Thank you. I wouldn't expect anything less from you, big boy.
I love you, bro. I really do.
Too.
So, Deshaun, you never act entitled. You almost act like you're the two-star guy. You're the guy that people doubt. You had a couple drop touchdown passes. Your energy didn't drop. Welcome to the Elite 11. Thank you. Well, big moment, the Elite 11 MVP. What comes with it? The coolest thing comes with it is a play will be named after you. This guy was stone cold killer from the second he showed up on campus. Your 2013 MVP, Sean White. How good does that feel?
Everybody come up here.
Come on, guys.
Everybody up.
I almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it.
Don't look down. Look up, because that's where you're going. There's so much more in there than anybody's ever given you credit for. If there's anything I want to teach you guys, keep climbing.
One, two, three,
keep climbing!
There's always gonna